हाँ जी गाइस, गुड इवनिंग, वेलकम टू एडुटैप। सो दिस लेक्चर इज़ डेडिकेटेड टू यूपीएससी ईपीएफओ 2020 एंड दिस इज़ अ सीरीज ऑफ स्कीम्स, सोशल सिक्योरिटी स्कीम्स, इन विच वी डिस्कस वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट स्कीम्स विच आर रेलेवेंट फॉर योर एग्जामिनेशन। एंड लेट मी टेल यू, दिस इज़ योर लेक्चर नंबर 13। सो आई बी वेटिंग फॉर फ्यू ऑफ यू टू जॉइन एंड देन विल स्टार्ट द डिस्कशन ऑफ अनदर स्कीम, रादर टू स्कीम्स आई हैव ब्रॉट फॉर यू टुडे। So, let's just wait for a few seconds to for the students to join in. Okay, so few of you are here. दुर्लभ इज हियर, गुड इवनिंग। सौरभ, धनेश्वर, अर्नब, जितेंद्र, सो हाउ आर यू ऑल गाइज? आई होप योर प्रिपरेशन इज गोइंग रियली गुड एंड दिस इज़ अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कॉम्पोनेंट। एंड येस, दोज ऑफ यू हु आर न्यू हियर, लेट मी टेल यू दैट यू मस्ट गो बैक एंड सी द प्ले लिस्ट इन विच वी हैव कवर्ड प्रीवियस सोशल सिक्योरिटी स्कीम्स एंड रादर देर आर मल्टीपल लेक्चर्स गोइंग ऑन फॉर यू पी एस सी पी एफ ओ 2020, सो यू कैन रेफर टू ऑल दोज लेक्चर्स। चलो, तो Virendra is also here. Very good evening. So guys, meanwhile, I want to tell you about the comprehensive course that is being offered by EduTap for UPSC PFO. So we have brought a comprehensive course in which we provide full video course for the three most important components: industrial relation, labor law, social security and general accounting. So these are three very, very important topics, subjects or components of your syllabus, and these are covered through a video course. For general studies, which include freedom struggle, polity, economy and science, we have provided complete handouts. So you refer to these handouts or notes and you are done with these subjects. Then we are providing current affairs magazine starting from Jan 2020 up till the month your exam takes place. Adding on that, we have sectional tests, full length test and revision classes along with regular live classes. ठीक है? तो चलो फिर, आई कैन सी मेनी ऑफ यू हियर, आई विल जस्ट बिगिन द लेक्चर, मीन वाइल स्टूडेंट्स विल एनी हाउ जॉइन इन। ठीक है, तो चलो स्टार्ट करते हैं। तो गाइज, वन इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग आई वॉन्ट टू टेल यू, एज यू कैन सी द सेटअप, द लेक्चर इज नॉट बींग टेकन फ्रॉम स्टूडियो, रादर दिस लेक्चर इज बींग टेकन फ्रॉम माई होम, सो प्लीज कोऑपरेट विद मी इन केस देर इज एनी काइंड ऑफ डिस्टर्बेंस। ओके, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। हियर इज योर वेरी फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम सोशल सिक्योरिटी स्कीम, एंड द क्वेश्चन इज, which of the following schemes has been designed to incentivize employers for the generation of new employment for which government of india will be paying the full employers contribution towards eps and epf? Okay, you have to identify the scheme. This is a typical question which is different in terms of UPSC civil services examination, the pattern, because here the acronyms of the schemes are given and you have to identify the scheme through its aim. ठीक है, तो ई पी एस एंड ई पी एफ वी हैव कवर्ड इन आर प्रीवियस स्कीम्स, एम्प्लॉयज प्रोविडेंट फंड स्कीम, एम्प्लॉयज पेंशन स्कीम, दीज आर टू डिफरेंट स्कीम्स वी हैव कवर्ड। सो यू हैव टू टेल दैट विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग स्कीम्स हैज बीन डिजाइन टू इंसेंटिवाइज द एम्प्लॉयर्स सो दैट दे कम अप एंड डेवलप जनरेट एम्प्लॉयमेंट, एन एस ए पी, पी एम युवा, पी एम के वी वाई और पी एम आर पी वाई। ओके, सो लेट मी सी द आंसर्स। भरत स्टूडेंट स्टोर, ऋषभ, दुर्लभ, सौरभ, ऑल ऑफ यू आर गोइंग विद ऑप्शन डी, दैट इज पी एम आर पी वाई, इज इट? आकांक्षा बदानी, अनूप, वीरेंद्रा, ठीक है गाइज, एन एस ए पी वी कवर्ड इन आर जस्ट प्रीवियस लेक्चर, है ना, नेशनल सोशल असिस्टेंस प्रोग्राम, तो वो आंसर नहीं हो सकता। तो पी एम आर पी वाई, इफ यू नो द एक्रोनिम व्हाट इज इट स्टैंड्स फॉर, यू विल नो द आंसर, इट्स प्रधानमंत्री रोजगार प्रोत्साहन योजना। सो दैट्स द आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन। पी एम आर पी वाई वॉज लॉन्च बाई द गवर्नमेंट इन द ईयर 2016। ठीक है, the nodal ministry of this scheme is Ministry of Labour and Employment. See, while reading any schemes, you have to know certain things like what was the launch year, which is the nodal ministry, or what is the aim of that particular scheme. ठीक है, or if any premium is associated with that scheme, if it's an insurance scheme, तो लाइक दैट बेनिफिशरीज एक्सेट्रा. तो दिस प्रधानमंत्री रोजगार प्रोत्साहन योजना हैज़ बीन डिजाइन टू इंसेंटिवाइज द एम्प्लॉयर्स सो दैट दे जनरेट न्यू एम्प्लॉयमेंट एंड अंडर इट गवर्नमेंट विल बी पेइंग ईपीएस कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ द ईपीएस एज वेल एज ईपीएफ कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ द न्यू एम्प्लॉयमेंट. Apart from that, the other schemes which were mentioned, NSAP we have covered earlier. Please go back and see that, the video, the previous one. NSAP aims at ensuring minimum national standard for social assistance in addition to the benefits that are already being provided. So it's a kind of a social assistance program where poor people are identified and they are given benefits to assist them. Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana, from the name itself you can see it is basically about skill training, Kaushal Vikas. To enable a large number of Indian youth to take up industry relevant skill training so that they can have a better livelihood and better employment opportunities. Finally, Pradhan Mantri Yuva Yojana. So this is again at enabling ecosystem for entrepreneurship development through education and training. So I can see some of the questions in between. ठीक है गाइज, आई विल टेक द क्वेश्चन आफ्टर द लेक्चर. अभी इधर फोकस करते हैं. पवन प्लीज कम अप विद अ क्वेश्चन आफ्टर द लेक्चर. फाइव क्वेश्चन आर देयर. ठीक है चलो नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग आर द बेनिफिट्स ऑफ इम्प्लीमेंटिंग प्रधानमंत्री रोजगार प्रोत्साहन योजना. तो वी हैव सीन द एम ऑफ इट. नाउ दिस इज अ क्वेश्चन वेर इन यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द बेनिफिट ऑफ इट. सो लेट्स सी इफ यू गाइज कैन डू इट. Option 1 is the employer is incentivized for increasing the employment base of workers in the establishment. So is it the benefit that if an employer increases the employment base, he or she is going to get incentivized? Second is a huge number of workers would find jobs in such establishments. So what do you think are the benefits of this scheme? A is 1 only, B is 2 only, C both 1 and 2, D neither 1 nor 2. So guys, this is a very easy question. We have just covered the aim, right, wherein employment would be generated and the people who are generating employment would be incentivized. So if you have understood that, it's very easy. Come on, all of you must try this question. Let me see. Some of the answers I've got: Bharat, Student Store, Rishabh, Akansha, Durlabh, Anoop, Ignite, Harsh, Rishiraj, Arnab. You guys are saying both 1 and 2. And that's right. Because the benefits are very simple here given. That we have seen through the aim that employer is going to get incentivized. And in turn, where employment is generated, workers are going to find jobs. So this is the benefit of it. Very nice, Virendra. So scheme, the thing you have to know about this scheme is that this scheme offers social security benefits of the organized sector to the workers. That is why this scheme is being covered here. Social security is a very important component, hai na? So the schemes which provide social security are very much relevant, be it old or new, as from the exam I'm telling you. So, there will be twin benefits. First of all, employer is going to get incentivized and thus the workers who get a job, they will also be under the ambit of social security benefits. To provide this particular thing, that benefits should be provided in the organizations to the employees, this scheme is being generated, implemented. Okay? Achha, one important thing. 8.33 we covered that EPS contribution by the government. So government of India EPF contribution is also here, that is 3.67%. So for the first 3 years, 2016 mein scheme implement hua tha, so for the first 3 years, 16 17 17 18 18 19, for these 3 years full contribution of the employer side would be given by the government of India. So EPF or EPS, this you have to know guys. From the experience of exam, let me tell you, ye jo percentage given hai idhar, you have to know this also. 8.33 3.67, because as I told you that even premiums can be asked, that what is the premium for this particular scheme hai na, which is paid. Similarly, this percentage is important. Chalo, next question. Which of the following is or are the eligibility criteria or criterias for the employees to be enrolled under PMRPY? So PMRPY, aapko pata hai, what is it? Let me see if you know this, the eligibility criteria. For the employees, not employers. So they should have joined in the establishment on or before 1/4/2016. So 2016 basically is the point here. They should not have been a regular employee in any EPF registered establishment prior to this. Monthly wages of the new employee should be less than ₹15,001. So, 15,000 is the basically upper limit here, this statement is saying. And all of the above are the eligibility criterias. Let's see again. Bharat Durlab and Student Store Anoop, 4 students have given the answer. Akansh and Rishabh D. Guys, come on, try. This is again not difficult at all. Although these are peculiar, that is, these are you have to remember these given the amount, the figure has been given, the year has been given. But since it was launched in 2016, so that is why A correct ho gaya. B is obviously, if they're already registered under EPF, then why would they be given enrolled under the scheme so that they can get social security benefit, hai na? So, ye bhi hona chahiye true. And third is, monthly wages should not be less than, should be less than 15,001. Theek hai? So, this is also correct. D is the answer. That's right. All of the above are the eligibility criteria for the employees. So, employees criteria, I've told you, these are the dimensions of a scheme to be covered for the examination. Coming to employee eligibility criteria for establishments, they also have to follow a few criteria. The first one is that establishment should be registered with EPFO, the body for which you are preparing, hai na, enforcement officer exam. So employees have to be registered with EPFO and have a valid LIN. What is LIN, guys? Labor Identification Number. This is very important. This is given to the establishments basically. So Shram Suvidha Portal is the one on which an establishment can enroll and get their labor identification number. So jaise PIN hota hai, personal identification number, PAN account number hota hai, aise LIN bhi rehta hai. And they should have a valid PAN, organizational PAN, and they have added new employees after 1/4/2016. So wahi jab 2016 mein launch hua, employees should have joined after that. Establishments should have enrolled employees after that only. Theek hai? चलो आगे चलें फिर. अच्छा गाइस, दोज ऑफ यू हु आर बेसिकली क्यूरियस अबाउट द टाइप ऑफ वर्क व्हिच इज व्हिच यू हैव टू डू एज अ पार्ट ऑफ ईपीएफओ और व्हाट इज काइंड ऑफ लाइफ ईपीएफओ ऑफिसर लीड्स, फॉर दैट यू कैन रेफर टू अ वीडियो. We have posted that video. That video is by EPFO officer itself. Please refer that video. ठीक है, playlist में रहेगा. Strategy बताई है sir ने. EPFO officer हैं. Last 2018 में select हुए थे. You can refer to that. You'll have a clarity about all this. चलो आगे चलें. प्रधानमंत्री कौशल विकास योजना इज एप्लीकेबल टू एन इंडियन नेशनल. तो वी आर नाउ मूविंग टू नेक्स्ट. प्रधानमंत्री RPY डन. नेक्स्ट इज प्रधानमंत्री कौशल विकास योजना की एप्लीकेबिलिटी यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई. लेट्स सी. इंडियन नेशनल हु इज अनएम्प्लॉयड, कॉलेज और स्कूल ड्रॉप आउट. ठीक है. सेकेंड इज हैज अ वेरीफिएबल आइडेंटिटी प्रूफ, दैट इज आधार कार्ड, वोटर कार्ड और इवन अ बैंक अकाउंट. एंड अ बैंक अकाउंट, नॉट और, बिकॉज दैट मीन्स प्लस इट हैज टू बी. एंड फाइनल इज हैज कंप्लीटेड एटलीस्ट द स्कूलिंग टिल 8th स्टैंडर्ड. तो सिलेक्ट द करेक्ट आंसर यूजिंग द कोड्स गिवन बिलो. 1 and 2 ओनली, 2 and 3, 1 and 3, ऑल 1 and 2, 1, 2 and 3. तो एप्लीकेबिलिटी यू हैव टू टेल फॉर प्रधानमंत्री कौशल विकास योजना. नए स्टूडेंट्स और 15,001 तक कर सकते हैं. लेट्स सी फोर्थ. अच्छा अगेन डी. वीरेंद्र इज चूजिंग 1 and 2. Rishabh is going with D, Anoop going with D, Varsha going with D. So till now, 2 questions we have covered, jinka answer was all of the above. So you guys have thought probably this question's answer is also D, hai na? Nayan Jyoti, Akanksha, Rishi Raj is going with B, 2 and 3, okay. Anyone else? D nahi hai iska answer, guys. It's 1 and 2. Not 1 and 3. Okay, acha, there's garbar glitch. I'll correct it. A, it has to be 1 and 2 only. So applicability mein it does not count 8th standard. ठीक है. College dropout हो गए, unemployed हो गए, तो उसमें 8th standard का तो मतलब ही नहीं बनता बीच में, है ना. नहीं, it's not even 10th pass. Coming to the scheme. प्रधानमंत्री कौशल विकास योजना लॉन्च्ड इन 2015 एंड नोडल मिनिस्ट्री मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ स्किल डेवलपमेंट एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप. ये तो इजी है, कौशल विकास स्किल डेवलपमेंट मिनिस्ट्री करेगा. इंप्लीमेंटिंग एजेंसी NSDC नेशनल स्किल डेवलपमेंट कॉरपोरेशन. गाइज ईच एंड एवरी लाइन गिवन हियर कैन बी अ सेपरेट क्वेश्चन इन इटसेल्फ. प्लीज note down all these things. Objective, to enable a large number of youth to take up industry relevant skill training to help them get a better livelihood. This we have covered in question 1 ka explanation. Beneficiaries, only 2 criteria are here. First of all, person has to be unemployed, youth, college and school dropout. Second is identity proof, either Aadhaar or voter card plus a bank account should be there. That's it. You do not need to be 8th, 10th or 6th pass. Theek hai? I hope now you understand this thing. Pradhanmantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana. Last question of the lecture is here. Again related to Pradhanmantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana. Which of the following is incorrect regarding PMKVY? So incorrect, you can see as it is written in italics. So because this exam is in pen paper mode guys, so please be careful very much. Incorrect will be written like this only in some italics form. So you have to identify that. Theek hai? Chalo, incorrect let's try to identify. Training in soft skills, entrepreneurship, financial and digital literacy will be imparted at short term training centers. Under Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana. B is individuals with prior learning experience or skills shall be assessed and certified. C is skill training under the scheme would be closely monitored by Niti Aayog. D, placement opportunities would be provided to candidates who are trained and certified under the scheme. So let me see how many of you know this answer. Incorrect identify karna hai, this let me tell you. Be very careful. तो ऑल ऑफ द अबव तो है नहीं है, अदरवाइज यू गाइज वुड हैव चोजन दैट ओनली. आई कैन सी आकांक्षा, नैन ज्योति, स्टूडेंट स्टोर, न्यूटन, वर्षा, वीरेंद्र. You guys are choosing option C. And if you go by the logic, you should choose option C because we have covered question 4 and in that we did not mention or we did not see Niti Aayog anywhere. So how can a body which is not at all involved in the implementation, which is not even related to the implementation of the scheme, how can it be used for the monitoring purpose? So yes, of course, C is incorrect. Skill training under the scheme would be monitored by Niti Aayog is incorrect. Okay, C. Let's see the features so that you understand it better. Short-term training at training centers of PMKVY will benefit the candidates of Indian nationality. We have seen eligibility, school, college dropouts and unemployed. Then training would be given in soft skills, entrepreneurship, financial and digital literacy. All these things you have to keep in mind. Then RPL is a very important component of this Yojana. RPL is recognition of prior learning. That means individuals who have skills already. Let me give you an example. See, if a person is doing the task of the profession involved, he is in plumbing, for example, he is a plumber and he has a rich experience of 10 years, theek hai? Or let's say 15 years. So that will be recognized under it and a certificate would be provided as RPL certificate. That means that person, the work which he does or she does has been recognized by the government, theek hai? Then placement opportunities are also going to be provided. They will get them, try to get them placed at some organizational level. And monitoring, obviously, Niti Aayog ka kahi naam nahi hai, so it cannot monitor it. For monitoring anything, you have to be a part of that particular thing, right? So to ensure high standards of quality, NSDC, National Skill Development Corporation, and inspection agencies will be involved and they will be using various methods to assess all these things, theek hai? Chalo guys, that's it from my end. We have covered very important questions. I hope you enjoyed the session and you found it very beneficial. I am really hoping that. So now I'll be waiting for few of you. Those of you who have any query, please you can ask me now because I don't prefer to take queries in between. Students get distracted, right? So I'll be here with you to take your queries. Theek hai? Do let me know how did you like this lecture, or you can also let me know which scheme would you want me to take up. Do mention the same in the comments below. What is the thing you liked about the lecture? Okay, and what next you want me to come up with? Students tour, you download the PDF of this particular lecture. Telegram channel pe jana, pura dekh lena wahan se PDF. Thank you so much, Virendra, for the motivating words. You're welcome, Arnab. इंग्लिश को कैसे इम्प्रूव करूँ? सी, इंग्लिश को इम्प्रूव करने के लिए आई वुड सजेस्ट प्रैक्टिस करो ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा, है ना. कुछ बुक्स, बेसिक बुक्स हैं, उनको रेफ़र कर सकते हो. इंग्लिश ट्राई टू सी, अंडरस्टैंड, प्रैक्टिस ही इज़ द थिंग. ठीक है, अब इस टाइम पे यू शुड सी व्हाट इज़ रेलेवेंट फॉर द एग्जामिनेशन, तो उसी हिसाब से करो इम्प्रूव. यू आर वेलकम गाइज. संतोष, आकांक्षा, तरुण भट्ट, टेलीग्राम चैनल का लिंक इज़ इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ दिस वीडियो. यू प्लीज़ गो बैक, नहीं, नॉट गो बैक, गो टू द डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ दिस वीडियो. वहाँ पे रहेगा टेलीग्राम का लिंक, ब्लू लिंक होगा, उस पर क्लिक करना एंड यू विल बी टेकन टू द टेलीग्राम चैनल. देर इन आई विल बी पोस्टिंग द PDF. यू कैन डाउनलोड द PDF फ्रॉम देर. थैंक यू सो मच ऋषभ जैन, थैंक यू सो मच. आई एम रियली ग्लैड दैट यू लाइक दीज स्कीम्स. वीरेंद्र, कॉमेंट्स में मैंशन करना प्लीज़, क्योंकि चैट का ट्रैक नहीं रहता है. But I'll definitely take cognizance of the comments written. That is why I say, जो भी you want me to take up next, उसको mention कर दो comments में, और अपना कुछ feedback देना है तो comments में लिख दो. हाँ जी, class is over. You came late, I think, Anil. तो वी ट्राई टू टेक मैक्सिमम आउट ऑफ दीज 25 to 30 minutes in which I try to cover बहुत सारे questions, important ones आपके लिए. ठीक है, तो आई डोंट थिंक एनी अदर क्वेरी यू हैव. तो गाइज, डू विजिट आवर वेबसाइट www.edutab.co.in. देर इन यू कैन सी द फीचर्स ऑफ आर कोर्स दैट आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू इन द बिगिनिंग ऑफ द लेक्चर. दोज हु आर न्यू हियर, गाइज, सब्सक्राइब टू आर चैनल एंड विजिट आवर वेबसाइट. एंड इन केस ऑफ एनी कंसर्न, एनी क्वेरीज, प्लीज फील फ्री टू ड्रॉप अस अ मेल एट hello@edutab.co.in. ठीक है, थैंक यू सो मच स्टूडेंट्स टूर. तो आई विल बी टेकिंग योर लीव गाइज, बाय बाय, टेक केयर, एंड आई विल सी यू नेक्स्ट ट्यूजडे विद अनदर सेट ऑफ MCQs. एंड येस, ऑफकोर्स, कॉमेंट्स में मैंशन कर दो जो स्कीम यू वुड वॉन्ट मी टू टेक अप, और एल्स आई विल टेक अप अ स्कीम विच आई फील इज इम्पॉर्टेंट. चलो, बाय गाइज.